Time synchronization. In this video, we will see how to properly set up a time synchronization in a Desigo control point system. First, we have to define some basic terminology. The NTP or Network Time Protocol is a networking protocol that guarantees an accurate synchronization of devices' clocks. The NTP server is the reference time server that is in charge to provide the accurate date and time. The Time Master, or also Master Clock, is the device that distributes the synchronized time get from a specific NTP server to one or more devices within its own network. In a typical Desigo system, the Time Master function is suggested to be covered by the management station, like Desigo CC. If the management station is not available, this function can be covered by the automation station. Desigo control point devices offer now the possibility to cover this function as well, so this is now possible to set a PXG3 web server or even the PXM touch panels as Time Master. But we recommend to do that only if no automation stations are available. However, the PXM touch panels are not equipped of a super cap, which would guarantee to keep the date and time information for a certain time if the hardware is powered off. For that reason, if no automation stations are available, it is always recommend to set the Time Master function on a PXG3 web server device, which is instead equipped of a super cap. In our example, we have a PXC4, a PXC5, a DXR2 room automation station, and a PXG3W202 web server, plus a PXM30 touch panel. The PXC4 automation station IP settings are configured in order to be able to reach a Siemens NTP server, available over internet. So, a default gateway is defined, as well as a preferred and an alternative DNS servers. The PXC4 device will be set as Time Master by this option, and the NTP server address is indicated in this field. In the UTC synchronization table, the local broadcast is automatically set, which means that all the devices of the PXC4 network will be synchronized. If we want to restrict the synchronization to just one or more devices, we can add a specific device instance number, which is available in the BACnet information of the device, or also in the specific column from the engineered device table. If this table is no entry at all, then the synchronization would not properly work. The devices will be automatically synchronized following a predefined interval, which is normally 150 minutes. When it is set to zero, the time synchronization is disabled. However, the synchronization will be executed even if the time of the Time Master is changed. Perform now a full load of this new configuration to the Time Master device. Once ready, we can test the synchronization. On the left side, we have opened a web session to our web server, and on the right side, we do the same for the PXC4 device, which is our Time Master. Browsing in the PXC4 web interface through the object view, then device and infrastructure, we can find the device BACnet instance number. And we can access some properties where we can see the current date and time set on this device. We now manually change the time of the PXC4 automation station. We can see that the web server automatically synchronizes the date and time to its own Time Master. We could now wait for 150 minutes so that the automation station will synchronize itself to the NTP server, or we can manually change back the time. The time synchronization is properly set.